Alrighty, Kelsey, you there?
Hello.
G'day, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Very well, thank you. Give it another couple of minutes, and then I think we'll get started.
Stunning.
Fantastic. And you good to live tweet rather?
For sure.
Good oh. Who have we got here? We've got Jasmine, we've got May, we've got Renee. Thanks very much for making the time on the public holiday, guys. We'll be uploading a video on demand on YouTube as well after the ceremony, so I'm recording this. So if anybody does miss the ceremony, and given that it's a public holiday, that's a total possibility. We'll just chuck it on there, and we'll see how we go. Alrighty, Roo, I think it's time that we get started. Alrighty, so without further ado, I guess we'll get things going. So thanks very much for coming to the Bloggies for 2020, everybody. My name's Callum Harvey, and I'm the president and co-founder of the University of Wollongong Digital Media Society. UOWDMS is the only student society for communication and media, digital media, and journalism students at the University of Wollongong. We're a community of over 250 students, and we work to create networking opportunities, locate work opportunities for our students, and help create a little community within the Bachelor of Communication and Media degree. So this is the first time that we've run the Bloggies personally. Previously, the ceremony was run by Renee Middlemost, and we'd like to thank Renee very, very much for giving us the reins this year. It's been a very, very exciting and very, very tough semester, and we're really glad that we've all seemed to have made it to the end of it relatively unscathed. So without further ado, we'll get things going. Just a little bit of housekeeping first. If you do receive an award, the certificates will be shared on Twitter. And if you receive one, please show it off. Record an acceptance video and share it to the hashtag Bloggies2020 on Twitter. You're more than welcome to tweet to any of the subject hashtags as well, just to keep up with the ceremony, which is exciting. Video of the ceremony will also be uploaded to YouTube afterwards. And we'd also like to give a very special thank you to Patty Hain, who designed the Bloggies logo for this year that we saw just here. Patty's a first-year student studying the Bachelor of Communication and Media, and if you do want an incredible logo for a digital artifact, small business, whatever, definitely go to Patty because he's a great friend of the society and he's done some incredible work for us. So thank you very much, Patty. I've got a few more people joining. Thanks very much for joining us, Wendy and Carly. And we'll get started. So the first award for this session or for this ceremony is the Best BCM 112 Digital Artifact. This category had more nominees than any other category, a total of 25 different digital artifacts. Total of 25 different digital artifacts, sorry there. And so we'll get into the finalists. The finalists are the Major Trouble podcast, Tierra Earth by Emily Murphy, Territorial Presets by Tori Saros, That Booze Bloke by Ross Kyriatsis, and AMC Design Studio by Alex Cooper. We had over 25 unique digital artifacts nominated this session, and we think that's a really incredible testament to the great work that digital media students have completed over the last session, especially considering the pandemic. So, and the winner is Tori Saros for Territorial Presets. We absolutely loved what Tori put together over this session. Tori creates Adobe Lightroom presets for use on Instagram and other social media platforms. And what she's put together with Territorial Presets is an incredible example of what you can do if you monetize a digital artifact. She creates some awesome content on Instagram, and we thoroughly encourage you to go check her stuff out. Congratulations, Tori. And just as a reminder as well, once again, if you do receive an award, we'd love for you to tweet it a acceptance speech on the hashtag Bloggies2020 on Twitter. Next up, we've got the Best BCM 112 Blog. The finalists are Emily Murphy, Trent Olchin, Bella Anastowski, Taylor Simage, and Yaz Reldy. And if I have mispronounced any of those surnames, I do apologize. Please feel free to shout it out in the chat or just interrupt me on the voice chat as well. And the winner for Best BCM 112 Blog is Trent Olchin for my digital artifact pitch. Not only did we love the way that Trent's website or WordPress blog was put together, but he did create a very comprehensive pitch and blog post, and it is really his testament to what he's putting together as one of the many members of the Major Trouble podcast team. Team does seem to be expanding as time goes on, so congratulations, Trent. Alrighty, next up, BCM113 blog finalists. Again, another very competitive category. The finalists are Emily Cousins, Bella Anastowski, Jess Steele, Alana Namovsky, and Joseph Sayun. And once again, with the surname thing, if you do feel compelled to interrupt me, if I've mucked up pronunciation, please do so. Oh. Kelsey, would you like me to slow down for live tweeting purposes? I'm happy to do that. Sorry, Kelsey, I just saw your chat.
No, all good, keep going.
All right, cool, cheers. All right, awesome. Thanks very much. Alrighty, so the winner for best BCM 110 blog is Bella Anastowski for BCM 110 week 5. This is a really great blog post that we loved. It covers Jürgen Habermas, it covers the public sphere, it covers political content online, and it covers TikTok and other short video social media platforms. We really loved this. It was a great little blog post, and congratulations to Bella for winning this one. Kelsey, was the timing appropriate for you? I'm so sorry. I will endeavor to slow down. Okay. Next up, best Twitter personality. This is for BCM 110 and BCM 112. The finalists are Casey Picciarilli, Megan Webster, Yaz Reldi, Emily Cousins, and Joseph Sayun. This is a very competitive category once again, considering that everybody in this category who was nominated is a professional shitposter in their own right. So you should be very proud of yourself, whether you were nominated, whether you're a finalist, no matter what. And the winner for best Twitter personality is Casey Picciarilli. Not only is Casey an incredible meme maker in her own right, she's also the second member of her family to win this award. We believe that her sister Georgie won this award a couple of years ago. So we like to keep things in the family here at UOW DMS. So congratulations, Casey. Just looking at that Twitter header, oh boy. Okay, next up, best blog commenter finalists. The finalists are Trent Olchin, Olivia Tolado, Annie Pike, Patty Hain, friend of the show, and Jess Steele. And the winner is Annie Pike. A little bit about Annie there, and we do love the color on her blog as well. It's absolutely fantastic with a two-tone tan. Alrighty. Next up, we decided to name the Best BCM 113 Legal Explainer Award, which is a new award for this year, after Steinar Ellingsen. So the official Steinar Ellingsen Stands Award for BCM 113 Best Legal Explainer. The finalists are Jessica Anderson, Carly McNamara, Kira Sweet, Dylan Storer, and Trent Olchin. And the winner for the Steinar Ellingsen Stands Award for Best BCM 113 Legal Explainer is Jessica Anderson for Inspiration or Infringement, the case of Seafolly Proprietary Limited versus Fewstone Proprietary Limited. It was an incredible case. Not only did we love that the way this blog was written in the first place, but it was a really interesting insight into the way that the fashion industry treats intellectual property. Congratulations again, Jessica. Next up, another one of our very competitive categories for this year was Best Tweet. This one had about 30 different nominees, which was insane. And so we've collected a few of the best as our finalists, rather. So the finalists are Alana Namovsky, Megan Webster, featuring James Roche and Travis. Taylor Samage, for her tweeting of the Downfall parody Farewell. And Jessica Anderson, featuring Tori Saros. And the award goes to Alana Nomovsky. We love this one. It was very much reflective of how I think we were all feeling during the ongoing quarantine. And we really did enjoy just this format as well. It does harken back to those old Rage comics from the early 2010s. So congratulations, Alana. And thanks very much for engaging us with us as well on Twitter. You've done a really good job of that too. Next up, the Ted Mitev Award for Best Meme. Not only did we think it was appropriate for Ted to be the namesake for the Best Meme Award, considering his involvement and running of BCM112, an incredible subject, we also had trouble picking finalists because there were so many good memes, and we didn't think it was appropriate to have a shortlist that was anything less than 10 nominees. So we decided, rather than doing that, you can see any of the incredible nominees will be visible on Twitter. Feel free to retweet your favorite meme of this session as well. And the winner goes to Joseph Sayun for this awesome Doge Dust Storm piece, reflecting how I think we all feel sometimes during lectures. Okay, next up, we've got the Alex Mastronardi Award for Best Video. Alex Mastronardi is a former student and graduate of the Bachelor of Communication and Media and a co-founder of the Digital Media Society. In 2017, he won this award, which didn't have his name on it at the time, for a 7.5 minute long video about Star Wars. We thought it was not only a little bit ridiculous, but really cool that somebody would put in so much work for a remediation. So we decided to name the award after him this year. So the finalists are Tori Saros, Taylor Samage, the Major Trouble podcast team, Jacob Hoosman, and Yaz Reldy. And the winner is Taylor Samage for BCM112 Farewell, a parody of Downfall. And I think we're going to watch the whole thing right now.
Es ist dem Feind gelungen, die Front in breiter Formation zu durchbrechen. Im Süden hat der Gegner Zossen genommen und stößt auf Stahnsdorf vor. Der Feind operiert jetzt am nördlichen Stadtrand zwischen Frohnau und Pankow und im Osten ist der Feind bis zur Linie Lichtenberg-Marsdorf-Karlshorst gelangt.
Mit dem Angriff Steiners wird das alles in Ordnung kommen.
Mein Führer, Steiner
konnte nicht genügend Kräfte für einen Angriff massieren. Der Angriff Steiner ist nicht erfolgt.
Es bleiben im Raum Keitel, Jodl, Krebs und Burgdorf.
Ich kann nicht zulassen, dass die Soldaten, die für Sie verbringen...
Ist das Feiglinge, Verräter, Versager!
Mein Führer, was Sie da sagen, ist ungeheuerlich.
Die Generalität ist das Geschmeiß des deutschen Volkes. Sie ist ohne Ehren. Sie nennen sich Generale, weil Sie Jahre auf Militärakademien zugebracht haben, nur um zu lernen, wie man Messer und Gabel hält.
Jahrelang hat das Militär meine Aktionen nur behindert. Es hat mich jeden nur gekickert.
Widerstand in den Weg gelegt. Ich hatte gut daran getan. Und darin alle höheren Offiziere registrieren zu lassen, wie Stalin. Ich war nie auf einer Akademie. Und doch habe ich allein auf mich gestellt, ganz Europa erobert. Verräter! Von allem Anfang an bin ich so verraten und betrogen worden. Es wurde ein ungeheurer Verrat geübt am deutschen Volke. Aber alle diese Verräter werden bezahlen. Mit ihrem eigenen Blut werden sie bezahlen. Sie werden das saufen in ihrem eigenen Blut.
Bitte, Gerda, jetzt beruhig dich doch.
Meine Befehle sind in den Wind gesprochen. Es ist unmöglich, unter diesen Umständen zu führen. Es ist aus. Der Krieg ist verloren. Aber wenn Sie, meine Herren, glauben, dass ich deswegen Berlin verlasse, irren Sie sich gewaltig. Eher jage ich mir eine Kugel durch den Kopf. Tun Sie, was Sie wollen.
My goodness, that is exactly how I wanted to spend my Monday morning watching that video. So congratulations, Taylor, once again. That's a fantastic video, and we've also put that in the Discord chat. Oh my goodness, I have no words. I also got a request in the text chat from Meg saying, give us random facts in between awards. What's a random, if anybody has a random fact they want to chime in, but I'll kick this off by saying that the dot on the top of the letter I, the lowercase I, is called a tittle. That's spelled T-I-T-T-L-E. Camel milk is also pink, according to Meg. So that's horrifying. Let's move rapidly along so I don't have to think about camel milk. Thanks. My goodness. Alrighty, the award for best WordPress site design. We had a heap of finalists for this one, so we've got Annie Pike, Bella Anastowski, Hannah Kairos of Che Media, Yaz Reldy, and Bonnie Stonestreet. And the winner is Bonnie Stonestreet for this absolutely gorgeous video blog header. We opened this up and my jaw kind of dropped when we were going through the nominees for this award, because this is just a simply incredible piece of WordPress design, WordPress site design. So congratulations, Bonnie. You've done an absolutely fantastic job. Okay. Next up, the best podcast audio and audio remediation finalists. They are Retail Out Loud podcast, The Major Trouble podcast, and The Forced Friendship podcast. And the winner of this award is, and I don't think anybody will be too surprised, it's the Major Trouble podcast. Not only has this team grown over the course of the session, but they've consistently managed to put out high quality content even after we moved to an online only remote delivery model. They were previously putting out their podcasts using the podcasting studio in Building 25. They've since moved to remote delivery, and we thoroughly recommend that you check these guys out. They're a great example of what you can achieve with a group project. So congratulations to the boys from Major Trouble, or the team from Major Trouble, I should say. Alrighty, so that brings us to the end of the first half of our ceremony. We are going to change things up a little bit. The awards, the Bloggies previously only awarded, gave awards to first year students or students completing first year subjects. And we figured this year, seeing as we had a little bit of time on our hands, we'd expand it to include our BCM veterans. So these are students who are completing second or third year subjects, or if you're like me, you're in your fifth year and you're still doing second year subjects. and we thought this was a really great opportunity to recognize students completing subjects like BCM 212, BCM 325, and all the rest. So let's get started. Alrighty, the first award for the BCM veterans is Best Digital Artifact. This category is open to any student-run digital artifact outside of BCM 112. It doesn't necessarily have to be for a subject. It might have started in BCM 112 and is still running. But if it's run by a senior student, so anybody in second or third year, we decided to open the field up to these people. So the finalists, we didn't have any finalists because we had so many nominees for this category once again. So the winner of the Best Digital Artifact for the BCM veterans, and I don't think anybody will be too surprised, it's Che Media. Quite similar to the Major Trouble podcast, Che has continued to expand their team since beginning as a digital artifact in BCM 114, and they've since continued to grow. They have first year students, second year students, a couple of third year students, and our very own Kelsey Latham featured as the subject of an article in their latest volume, volume 3, or issue 3. So congratulations to the team at Che, and we hope to see very much more from you in the future. It's really exciting. Next up, Best Video. This category is open to any video content produced outside of first year subjects. Same rules applies as the digital artifact rule. This could be produced for a second year subject. This could even be produced for a non-BCM subject and shared to the hashtags, as long as it was nominated. Alrighty, and the winner for Best Video is Andy Bevel by Bodie Todd. This was a really harrowing piece of video content covering the events of the bushfire summer that we've just had. Bodie shared this to our Discord server, and we thought that it was just incredible, and it really cut to the heart of the issues faced by rural firefighting staff over the course of our horrible bushfire season that we've just had. So I think we'll watch the whole thing in full as well right now. Congratulations, Bodie, and enjoy, everybody.
We were working in Balmoral the day the fire broke its containment lines and run into the village, and that was on a Thursday. I think we lost about 11 houses that day, and the fire pretty much ran over the top of us. It was very unsettling experience. A lot of trees falling down and pretty scary. We've never fought a fire with the fuel moisture levels so low. So being in extreme drought, the fire was doing things with weather conditions that it never normally would do that. We had to improvise with water because they don't have a system like they do in the other villages. It's all tank water, so a lot of the times we'd get bulk water, semi-trailers coming in. Down in Balmoral, the actual train, We have it as a protection of life, protection of property, and then to reduce the impact in the environment with the fires. And the main goal with that green wattle fire, it run through Balmoral, and we end up losing 21 houses all up, I believe, down there. But the main goal with that was to keep it away from the populated areas. And you have different levels of emotion. Initially, the emotion was losing houses was a terrible thing, but then the next level up when we started losing lives, houses don't become so important. You'd say if a gum tree's about 25 metres tall on average, and the flames at times would be three times the height of that coming through there, and it's just right over the top here. So it'd have to be 60, 70 metre flame heights at least, and you're just that raw, it's like a steam train coming up. And yeah, it's, you know, you don't sort of see that every day, and you know, and all the fires I've done, there's stuff we've never seen. So Mother Nature's going to do what it's going to do, and we can only, we can do what we can do, and there's never enough fire trucks to go around, and when Mother Nature decides it wants to get that fire out running through them villages, you feel very inadequate for that, but you just got to sort of push on, but absolutely you do feel inadequate. If you don't do it, and everybody collaborated effort for thousands of people, you have no choice. And everybody's in the same boat, and everybody wears that on their shoulders. So this year round, other than some of the fires we had in the past, we've had the large air tankers, and we had a what's called a very large air tanker, or VLAT. And he's got a capacity of 44,000 litres, and they drop a substance called retardant, and what it does, it smothers the foliage, and it stops the oxygen going on the foliage, so as the fire hits it, it peters out. Yeah, that's all we have, is the community spirit, and without the community behind us, and you know, you only got to get on Facebook of a night time, and or people putting signs out the front, you know, saying thank you, and that keeps you going. If it wasn't for that, well, that's what you're doing it for, and the community realise. So, and you know, that it just gives every single firefighter a boost.
That was just fantastic. Congratulations once again to Bodie Todd for that harrowing piece. It was just absolutely incredible to watch that. Yeah, Bodie, I see you in the chat. Yes, congratulations. Alrighty, shall we move on to the next category? I think let's do that. Once again, something a little bit more lighthearted now, the best meme. So this category is open to any memetic content produced for a second or third year subject. Once again, as with the undergraduate category, we did have, well, the first year category, we had so many nominees, and any shortlist we would have produced would have been at least 10 entries long. So we figured we'll just cut to the chase and we'll give out the award. So the winner for best meme goes to Isabella Juano. I did not pronounce that right. I'm awfully sorry. For this awesome subversion of the distracted girlfriend format for The Matrix in BCM 325. So congratulations, Isabella. I had a little bit of a cackle at this. It's awesome. Yeah, this one got 83 likes and 22 retweets. So I think it might have actually broken out of the confinement of the old subject hashtag. It was just awesome. Okay, next up, we've got best BCM 212 research project. This is open to any research project in BCM 212. Once again, we did have a number of nominees for this, and so we figured we'd just cut to the chase, and we'll just give out the award. So the award for best BCM 212 research project goes to Frank Tremaine for How Does Music Affect Study? Frank is not only an incredible music journalist in his own right, but he set up an absolutely fantastic little infographic for his findings, and it really cut to the tugged at our heartstrings, considering that our society is built on vaporwave and lo-fi chill hop beats to study and listen to on YouTube. So congratulations, Frank. This is a really great piece of research, and we loved investigating it and having a look at it. Next up, best BCM 312 research project. I think you can guess as to what this one is. Open to any research project in BCM 312. And the winner for best BCM 312 research project is Emma Babick for Media Illiteracy and Conspiracy Theories. We loved the write-up for this, and it really does cut to the heart of what is going on social media with respect to coronavirus conspiracy theories and it covered things like anti-vax and communication in the public sphere as well. So congratulations to Emma. We absolutely loved this piece and its write-up. And this is also our final award for... pardon me. This is also our final award for the 2020 Bloggies. Best Twitter Personality, open. This category is open to anybody from BCM Twitter, and we literally mean anybody. Now, we did have a little bit of a challenge with picking the winner for this category. We received a huge amount of nominations, and a common thread that we had was that a number of the BCM teaching staff were nominated as well. It's only fair. They're Twitter users just like the rest of us. And we thought about it, and we pondered some more, and we decided that rather giving this award to any one specific user, we would decide to give it to a group. So the best Twitter personality open for 2020 are the BCM academic staff. As I think everybody knows, these guys have put in some incredible long hours to reconfigure our degree to run on remote delivery, and have been answering Twitter messages at all hours of the night. And we see this hard work, we recognize it, and we are so, so thankful that we've got an incredible academic staff running this degree. It absolutely wouldn't happen, and it certainly wouldn't have translated online as well as it did without your tireless work and incredible efforts. So thank you once again for your Herculean efforts in making this degree what it is in these challenging times. So thank you once again. You're very, very deserving. And with that brings us to the end of our ceremony. So thank you very much for a great session. I will remind you once again to tweet your acceptance speeches using the hashtag Bloggies2020. For anybody who is interested in joining the Digital Media Society, myself and most of the co-founding executives will be stepping down at the end of this session. Our annual general meeting will be happening during or after the break. Stay tuned for further information as to the positions. We've been doing a little bit of a marketing blitz as well, and Jasmine has just posted a blog post on becoming a DMS executive in the Discord chat as well, and we will put that in the YouTube description as well. Please stay tuned for further information on that, and this is an incredible opportunity to join a great organization that works very closely with faculty to deliver course content and support students. If you haven't already joined the Digital Media Society, our sign-up link is in our Twitter bio. Alrighty, does anybody else have any further comments, complaints about the award ceremony? Because otherwise, I think we'll see you online. Thank you very much for an incredible session, and we'll hopefully see you after the break. Good luck with your final assessments. Thanks, everyone.